Today I'm going to talk to you about the e-commerce growth formula and the order of operations in e-commerce. I've started as an e-commerce entrepreneur back in 2007, and I've made this terrible mistake for 3 whole years in a row. I'm Valentin Radu, and welcome to e-commerce tips. When I first started my activity as an e-commerce entrepreneur, I wrongly thought that this is the right formula. Traffic multiplied by conversion rate and multiplied by average order value will get me to the growth. The harsh reality is that I was missing out the most important thing, the balance between the customer lifetime value and customer acquisition cost. So how much am I spending to acquire a customer, and for how long and how much will I get as an e-commerce from that customer? That made me improve the formula. The ratio between the customer lifetime value and the customer acquisition cost is crucial because it allows you to see how much can you afford to acquire a new customer based on the predictive customer lifetime value of your former customers. Understanding this ratio is going to help your e-commerce not only because you're going to improve the KPIs, but also it will help you negotiate better terms with your VC investors if you want to raise money. The beauty of this ratio is that it captures in advance the problems that your e-commerce is going to have, while if you guide yourself only through the P&L and the cash flow, you are not going to see the future behavior of the customers that you are acquiring today. However, the customer lifetime value and the customer acquisition cost are also affected by other factors. For instance, customer lifetime value is strongly correlated with the customer experience. The good news is that you can monitor the customer experience by using the Net Promoter Score or the customer effort score. Another important KPI that affects the customer lifetime value is the customer retention rate. If you are unable to keep customers coming back and buy again from you, the customer lifetime value goes down. And of course, your margin. Margin is an important factor which is affecting your customer lifetime value because it shows you how much your e-commerce keeps after it pays the cost of goods sold. Don't fall in the trap to adjust things like the CTRs and the CPC. Don't waste your time in Google Analytics. It's better to look at the underlying factor which is affecting what truly matters for your e-commerce. Customer lifetime value should be your North Star metric, and customer acquisition cost should be closely monitored so that you can improve this ratio between the CLV and the customer acquisition cost. The other part, how many customers you acquire, of course, is going to be affected by the traffic and the conversion rate. I'm not saying not to monitor those, but maybe it's time to begin with the end in mind. Look at the ratio between the CLV and CAC before you pour more money in customer acquisition. To monitor customer lifetime value and customer acquisition cost, you can use Omniconvert Reveal. Of course, you could have the alternative to download the CSVs and do this manually, but that takes a lot of time and is kind of tedious, right? If you like this video, subscribe for more.